what's up, what's good? It's me, I'm back. So recently there's been a lot of events that I just joined and, you know, attended to, and there's so many things that kind of just added up. That's why I wasn't able to upload for the past 2 weeks. And, you know, to be honest, I really want to post more because I have so many challenges that I already filmed, but I can't just post everything because I don't want to saturate you guys with so much. But to give you guys a quick recap of what has been happening in between those challenges and those photo shoots, I'm doing this really quick video and Q&A as well, that, you know, some of the questions that you submitted on Twitter, Curious Cat, and also on Instagram. First, there were two studios that invited me to participate in their opening, which is here in Metro Manila. One in Taft, which is by The Stripe Studio, and the other one is Studio 808 across GMA in Quezon City. And to be honest, those two studios are great. I really want to say thank you for inviting me, especially to Stripe Studio for the guys Angelou, Ran, Jester, Michael Zacharias, and many more, to the flow and everything. Thank you so much for inviting me. And Studio 808, I guess I want to say thank you directly to Judith for inviting me to be a part of the team that won, or probably got chosen to be a part of the first few groups to be able to use the Studio 808. So just to give you guys a quick look at what happened during those shoots, first and foremost by Stripe Studio. It's really cool because they were accommodating, and during the opening there's a lot of food because it was really fun. Big thanks to the family of Angelou, and also to Angelou and the whole team, because I ate a lot there and I drank a lot and also took a lot of great photos. You know, mad props to our models. I forgot the names, but you guys know who you are. I'll put it in the video. I got some clips right here. By the way, they have really great equipment, so make sure to check it out. And also, if you want to know more about the prizes and everything, make sure to PM them. I'll put all the links in the description. It will be really great for you guys to check it out if you guys are around Taft or students in Benilde, Saintsco, LaSalle, and all those people, you know, from Taft. Next one is by Studio 808, which is across GMA. So they have great equipment as well. They have great space, a lot of backdrops. They have a continuous wall, and also a lot of really, really cool lights. So they have a really big space as well. So I think I'll be posting a separate video for this, so you guys can check out the whole set, because this was like a collaboration with the studio, and, you know, they were able to like have us use all the equipment that they have, which is really cool of you guys. They have a great speaker, by the way. We were jamming all day there. So number two. So recently I was invited by a really cool restaurant, which is Paradise. It is in SM Aura in BGC or The Fort, and it's in the second floor across Cotton On. And man, to be honest, the food there was crazy. I'm not just saying this because they invited me, but, you know, I want to be honest with you guys. Even back then when I do reviews, I'm honest. And the food was really spicy. There was a really, really spicy server. I forgot it, but I'll show you some clips right here that when I was there, you know, I was able to hang out with some of my fellow creators. And also big thanks to my manager for inviting me to be a part of this event also. And, you know, they served half of the menu, and man, man, it was really, really tasty. I wasn't able to handle the really spicy one. I love the taste. I definitely enjoyed the Shaolin Bao, the different colored ones. There are flavors for it, but yeah, that was my first time experiencing Shaolin Bao in different flavors, and it's kind of interesting. You know, some of them great, some of cheese, I think. So yeah. Anyway, still thank you to Paradise for inviting us, for having us there, the whole TMG group and the TMG creators. And, you know, to be honest, I'll come back. I'll do a video again for that, you know, for things that photographers should eat when they shoot. And as I mentioned, for the past couple of weeks, I will release a Q&A, another one, which will entertain more questions from you guys from Instagram, Twitter, Curious Cat, wherever you guys rant or question me. So first, this is from Kimber. So, pwede ba daw gumawa ng tutorials for Dead Tones? I guess I can, probably down the line. I'm still working on how I will make the tutorials in the upcoming weeks, but to be honest, there's so many tutorials already here on YouTube where it shows how to mute colors, which is basically the idea of dead tones or muting tones or killing tones. So you can check that out. So the next one is by Cam. So love tips. My God, this is not photography related, but I can drop some knowledge right there. So guys, if you guys are trying to fall in love with somebody, and you know, you feel like you're falling, guys, there's an option for you to rappel down and cautiously drop down, because sometimes you just free fall, you get hurt, you don't know where you're gonna drop. Sometimes it looks bright, but it's still vague, you know? Just know more about what you're trying to get into. Next one is by Rubelin Volante. San po ako natuto mag-shoot? I guess I can say that, you know, big thanks to my friends who invited me to do some portraits, and then we do it. Who else? I also checked Pinterest before, and then ginagawa ko kung anong nakikita doon, and then I experiment on how to like execute those with my style, with my flavor, and then Aral-aral lang, you know, trial and error, and you know, when you fail, you get to like push yourself out to become better. So also remember, guys, failure is part of the success. Wolf Boy Troy. So this guy, by the way, make sure to check out his IG feed. It has great content, video and photo, black and white, monotone. Crazy, man. Make sure to check it out. Who are your inspirations? Definitely it's gonna be comics. Comics is my base because I started with toys, and I'm a big fan of comic books, and also the colors and how it's, you know, so it has so much contrast back then, you know, and my layouts mostly are inspired by that. So yeah, and also by works of RJ Wolfgang. Who else? Stan Lee style when it comes to like the lines and everything. Who else? Ed and Glenna. His work is really cool. He has a different approach to it, so make sure to check it out. Mike and Lorda, what were my struggles when I started? Definitely coming up with great content every time. You know, when you get to do one thing for like a couple of weeks, sometimes you tell yourself, am I doing something that I like, or do I need to grow, or am I stagnant, or like just consistently plateauing or whatsoever? So minsan kailangan mo mag-improve, or trying to step down a bit para makabuelo ka to go up. So yeah, I think that was my struggles before, and I think one of the best things that I did before was to go outside my comfort zone. And this one is by It's Hannah. What is the hardest part of being an adult? Probably sustaining yourself financially and you know, getting on with the, you know, the pressure and everything. Kasi sobrang pressured minsan, kahit pagising mo pa lang, oh, ano gagawin ko? But you know, sometimes you just have to set some goals, like what I did here. I do it one by one. You can't just jump into it and just say, hey, I'm done. No. You have to do it step by step. There will be failures, there will be some setbacks, there will be some delays, and still you need to move forward. Ed and Krona, my God, guys, this guy, colorblind creative, make sure to check it out. Yung mga gawa niya recently, he's just going crazy with his work. Siguro tips for consistency without compromising the taste. I guess, you know, you don't have to be a discounted version or a cheaper version of somebody's style. You know what I'm saying? Yung sinasabi naman sa mga gumaya, I'm just saying, kumbaga, huwag mong gayahin step by step or color by color ng isang tao. Kasi minsan, you have to create your own flavor, you have to create your own ingredients, or you have to create your own dish para ma-distinguish na kung sino ka. Mamaya, pag nag-post ka, katulad ka lang ng gawa ni ano. Which is sometimes kind of discouraging, di ba? So, I guess yun lang naman tip ko, para hindi ko ma-compromise yung taste ko at consistent pa rin ako, I do something that is my style when it comes with the mix of what I'm inspired of. Kasi ayokong i-overlap lang yun ng peg ko tapos nawawala yung style ko. I don't like that. So right, this will be the last question, and I really enjoyed thinking about the answer for this one. Is college a degree in graphic design worth it? Definitely. Kasi, you know, everyone's approaching the digital age, everyone's going digital, everyone's online, they're promoting online, they're campaigning online, they're sharing online, they're voicing out online, they're ranting online, they're fighting online. And you know, sometimes you have, if you want to put your message out there, you have to do something digital, right? something that where everyone is in. So I think getting a college degree in graphic design is good, because career wise it will help you. Second, if you like it, go for it. Third, everyone's there always. Like right now, everyone's on their phone. They're like zombies and everything. So, and fourth, if you're looking for something that will somehow financially sustain you, yeah, there is money and there is fun and career here. So anyway, so I think that's all for now. Oh my God, sobrang nakapagod i-recap lahat, pero I think this helps me regain more of myself rather than just being a part of me. Parang photographer and creator lang ang sinishare ko lagi sa inyo. So, I want to share my life and say to you guys. So, thank you guys for watching this video, and make sure to stay tuned to the next video, which is a new photo challenge. We're back. Peace!